Welcome to YouTube channel Physics Theories and Numericals, where we are providing you high quality videos for easy and joyful understanding of physics theories and concepts for life. Once you understand the theories, handling of MCQs and numericals will be easy. Also welcome to the best MCQ series videos for CBSE Class 10 Physics. We have designed this best MCQ series of videos with lot of care. Here we are providing you high quality MCQs. We will be starting from very basic level and we will be moving on to more difficult level of MCQs. With each and every MCQ, we will be providing you the explanation so that you can refresh your concept and strengthen them. This is just not a video. This is a mock test also. Here, with each and every MCQ, we are providing you reasonable time so that you can put in your thoughts. You can get to your options so that we can take you to the answer. So we will suggest you to use this video as a mock test. In this video, we are providing you 11 MCQs. So it will be around 15 minutes video. So if you calculate, you will find you will get a very high learning volume to the time spent ratio. So we will suggest you to go through the entire video and enjoy the high quality MCQs and take the learning from it. For your chapter 10, we have already uploaded 8 videos. 3 videos for spherical mirror, 2 videos for reflection, and 3 videos for lens. We will give you the links of the video in the description box so that you can go through in case you have not already gone through. This video is for human eye. Here comes the first MCQ, MCQ number 1. Human eye is a camera. The screen on which the image is formed is called 4 option. 10 seconds time for you. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is retina. The image is formed on the retina. Next MCQ. In a camera, diaphragm controls the aperture to regulate the amount of light that should get into the camera. I have given a picture here. In our eye system, which part you would identify as the diaphragm and aperture? Again, 4 options for you. 10 seconds time. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is option A, that is iris and pupil. Iris acts as the diaphragm and pupil as the aperture. Next MCQ, fill in the blank. The nature of the lens human eye has is, what type of a lens it is, and the image formed is, type of the image. 4 options, 10 seconds time. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is option C. The nature of the lens human eye has is a convex lens, and the image formed is real image and inverted image. Next MCQ, you need to identify the parts of our image. The picture of the eye has been given and with some parts marked as 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, in the left column, these numbers have been given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in the right column, the names have been given. So you need to choose from the option which number is for which name. You have about 15 seconds time here. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is option D. That is, serial number 1 is iris, 2 is pupil, 3 is cornea, 4 is lens, 5 is retina. Hope you are liking this video. Your response is very important to us. Please subscribe to the channel, like, share and comment on the video and press the bell icon. Let's continue. Next MCQ. In human eye, the energy conversion takes place in the retina from what to what? Light energy to mechanical energy, light energy to electrical energy, light energy to heat energy, or no energy takes place. The retina itself gives us the picture. 10 seconds time for you. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is option B, light energy to electrical energy. The light sensitive cells on the retina converts the light to electrical signals, which goes to our brain, which frames the image for us. Next MCQ, hypermetropia. 3 statements have been given for hypermetropia with the options marked in the red. You need to choose the correct options for hypermetropia. 15 seconds time for you. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is option C. That is, hypermetropia is somebody who is suffering from farsightedness. He is unable to see nearby object, and to correct the vision, he requires a convex lens. Picture has been given. From this you find out what is the type of defect and what lens is to be used to correct that. 10 seconds time for you. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is option B. The picture that has been given is for myopia, and to correct myopia, concave lenses are used. Next MCQ. Now, somebody who has got both the defects, both long vision and close vision, so he requires a bifocal spectacle. That is, a spectacle with bifocal lens is used to correct both the long vision defects and close vision defects. You identify the correct statement. For the spectacle, upper part is concave and lower part is convex. Or upper part is convex, lower part is concave. Or both the parts are convex or both the parts are concave. 10 seconds time for you. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is option A. That is, upper part is concave lens because it is for looking at far objects, and lower part is convex because it is for looking the near objects, like say for reading or something close. So it's option C. That is, upper part of the spectacle is concave lens and lower part is convex lens. Hope you are liking this video. Again, your response is very important to us. Please subscribe to the channel, like, share and comment on the video, and also press the bell icon. Let's continue. Next MCQ. What type of lens is used in the sunglass used by the cricketers? Convex, concave, photochromatic, or no lens is used? 10 seconds time for you. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. Answer is no lens is used. Because lens to be used if somebody has got defect in their vision. Now sunglasses is only for protection of the eyes. So it does not need to bend the rays. So the sunglass, they are basically plain glass. So no lens is used in sunglass. Next MCQ. What is the value of minimum distance of distinct vision, or say least distance of distinct vision? 10 centimeter, 20 centimeter, 25 centimeter, 30 centimeter. 10 seconds time for you. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. So it is 25 centimeter. Next MCQ, in fact last MCQ for this video, you choose the correct statement. Having two eyes helps us to, four options, have a 360 degree view, to look beautiful, to understand how far an object is, and better sight in the darkness. Which one is correct? 10 seconds time for you. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is to understand how far the object is. For us to understand the depth of the vision, how far an object is. Hope you like this video. Please subscribe to the channel, like, share and comment on the video. Thank you for watching this video. We will come up with many such videos. Bye bye till then.